Let's go across to NDTV, Saurabh Gupta, who's been tracking these protests as well as the clashes. What is the situation right now on the ground there, Saurabh?
Well, water cannons have been used in several places. So has tear gas been used, because obviously there were protests that were taking place in different locations as part of the Nobanno Obhijan or the March to Nobanno protest, given the call for which was given by a body which claims to represent students. But the police, of course, said that that body was not registered, and not part of any, organization that was registered as a student's body. However, that call was given. And, of course, the police said that they anticipated violence. Now, of course, they put up barricades, etc. And they also, brought in these water cannons and Vajra vans that you see in these pictures behind me to stop the protesters from marching towards Nobanno. However, some of the protesters tried to break those barricades. They also pelted stones, following which the police also used lathi charge and also used tear gas shells to disperse the crowd. And since then, of course, a group of protesters, however, have been peacefully protesting on the street, on the main carriageway of the Kona Expressway. And this is the road that leads out of the city towards the highway. So as far as these protesters are concerned, because they've been peaceful and not been trying to breach the barricades and not been trying to force past the police barricades, they've been allowed to sit here and protest and continue with their protest. However, anyone who's, of course, trying to breach the barricades and, cause problems, in those cases, the police, of course, are acting and apprehending them. In fact, if you see the police, whoever they've detained them in ones and twos after identifying them as miscreants who were part of the troublemakers. Largely, though, otherwise, people who were protesting, like here, peacefully, you can see a group of people sitting down and protesting. Those people have been allowed to continue with their protests as well. So this is the situation, though. In other parts of the city, for example, at Howrah Bridge, etc., water cannons have had to be used. Here, water cannons have not been used, but this has also become a major political issue with political rhetoric between the BJP and the Trinamool. The BJP says these are peaceful protesters and students who were protesting. The Trinamool says these were not students. These were, if you see them, there are others who joined and hijacked the students' protest and tried to incite violence. And, of course, this political rhetoric, of course, has continued. But meanwhile, the protests also continue behind me. But at this point, the situation is calm, even though the police are on alert and on standby with their riot control gear. For as long as the protesters remain like this and, silently protest, the police will not do anything. In fact, if I can ask my camera person to come this side and give you another idea of, visuals, some protesters also remain here at the entrance of the Santragachi station where, they've taken shelter. So Santragachi station subway entrance, some protesters still remain. And also, you can see, of course, the protesters on this side continuing their protest as we speak here and, continuing to block the main carriageway of the Kona Expressway here in Santragachi in Kolkata.
That's right, Saurabh. And as you said, the BJP, calling Mamata a tyrant, saying she's trying to stop this student march. This march is over, demanding that Mamata step down and justice for the junior doctor. So, the Trinamool Congress, however, hitting out and claiming that this is a deliberate attempt to, impact the law and order in Kolkata.
The Trinamool's response to this is that if, as long as you demand justice for the victim, as long as you, press for speedy trial, and identify...
Right, Saurabh, sorry to interrupt you. We're just going to go across to where the police is speaking. Let's listen in. Stay with us.
देखिए अभी सिचुएशन पूरी तरह से कंट्रोल में है. जितने लोग अरेस्ट हुए हैं, काफी मीडिया के दोस्त मुझे पूछ रहे हैं कि कितने लोग इंजर्ड हुए हैं, इसकी संख्या अभी हमारे पास नहीं है. शाम को जब सब जगह से डेटा कंपाइल होगा, उसके बाद लाल बाजार से ये डेटा जो है शेयर कर दिया जाएगा.
एक क्वेश्चन है आरजी कल को लेकर, एक जो वायरल वीडियो हुआ था कि सेमिनार हॉल का है, उसके बारे में क्या बोलेंगे? क्या सेमिनार हॉल का?
देखिए, जो प्लेस ऑफ अकरेंस है वो सेमिनार हॉल आरजी कर के थर्ड फ्लोर पे है। जो वीडियो शायद आपने देखा है जो बहुत वायरल हुआ है, उसमें देखा जा रहा है कि कुछ लोग खड़े हैं सेमिनार हॉल के अंदर। आपकी जानकारी के लिए बता दूं कि सेमिनार हॉल जो है वो 51 फीट बाय 32 फीट है। डेड बॉडी जहां पे मिली थी उस डेड बॉडी से 40 फीट बाय 32 फीट पूरा ही पुलिस ने कॉर्डन ऑफ किया था। बाकी की जो जगह थी वहां पे पेरेंट्स बैठे थे, हॉस्पिटल के डॉक्टर्स बैठे थे, वहां पे इमरजेंसी जो मेडिकल ऑफिसर रहता है वहीं पे उन्होंने बैठ के ब्रॉड डेड डिक्लेयर किया, और हॉस्पिटल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन से एक लॉयर साहब भी थे। तो इन लोगों को फैसिलिटेट करने के लिए वो जगह कॉर्डन ऑफ के बाहर वाली जगह थी, वो उनकी सुविधा के लिए रखा गया था। लेकिन जो कॉर्डन किया गया था, कॉर्डन के अंदर कोई नहीं आ पाया था।